In today's video, gents, we're having fun. I'm talking about my favorite picks, my favorite colognes, perfumes, fragrances from the top fragrance houses out there. All right, gents, I want to be straight up with you. This first choice was hard. You see, the house of Dior has been putting out fragrances since 1947. And honestly, in the last 50 years, these guys have put out some of the most amazing fragrances on the market. So should I have chosen a cologne from their classic collection? Or why not go with their bestseller, a fragrance that any serious collector, even if he hates it, he loves it because this fragrance right here gets you compliments. No, that'd be too easy. We should go with a fragrance not many people have heard of. Maybe a unique top note like pear, perfect for the summer. But that wouldn't work. It's getting cool. We're going into the winter. We want something strong, something that's going to put hair on your chest, something that smells like gasoline and grass. But I couldn't make up my mind. Should I go with the original or the Le Parfum? Guys, as you can tell, I'm bouncing all over the place. Maybe I should just go with something versatile, something you wear in the office, something you can wear at any time. No, screw that. I'm going to go with my heart. I'm going to go with the fragrances that pop up, the fragrances I'm wearing right now from this house, and that happens to be Sauvage Elixir. Now, if you haven't heard of this fragrance yet, that's cool. It just came out. It's a 2021 release. This is a modern masterpiece by Dior. Overall, it's a pretty versatile fragrance. You can wear this in the fall, you can wear this in the winter, spring, maybe not extreme heat in the summer. It has great longevity. We're talking 8+ hours with 3 sprays in the chest area, and projection is solid. You're going to get 2 feet the first couple hours. After that, it's going to go down to 1 foot, and then it becomes skin scent after about, like, I don't know, 12, 14 hours. Top notes are cinnamon, nutmeg, cardamom, and grapefruit. The middle note is lavender. The base notes are sandalwood, licorice, amber, patchouli, and Haitian vetiver. Now, this fragrance is not cheap. You're not going to find it at discounters. That being said, it should be widely available at stores that carry high-end fragrances, so you can get your nose on this, you can smell it, and you can say, hey, you know what? I like this, or Antonio is full of crap. Now, another word for fragrance house is fragrance brand, and that's what I'm talking about. All the fragrances I'm talking about, I'm going to look at a particular brand, this next one being Tom Ford. As you know, Tom Ford makes clothing, make a lot of other things, cosmetics and stuff, but fragrances are a particular area, and so I'm going through and looking at all the Tom Ford fragrances that I own, that I've used, and I'm going to share with you guys my favorites. So the first one I'm going to share with you is Tobacco Vanille. And this one, it almost made the list. This was my first love from Tom Ford. When I smelled this, I was like, wow, powerful, strong, unique. I love this fragrance. I bought it full retail, and to this day, it is still on my top 10 list. That being said, if that one sounds like too much for you, check out Oud Wood. A little bit more toned down. That being said, the oud, the wood, and there's not much oud in this, but this is just a beautiful scent. However, if I had to go with one Tom Ford fragrance, it would be Black Orchid. And I got to thank Steven over at Red Lessons for introducing me to this fragrance. This one right here, that truffle note, the chocolate, it's just so complex. It is sweet. It's a unisex fragrance, and I do not recommend you blind buy this one like I did. Point being is I smelled this and I loved it. I've never had anything that I've worn that I've just actually just, yeah, I mean, it's just beautiful. Warm, spicy, woody, earthy. I get a solid 8 hours out of this fragrance. It lingers, and it does become a skin scent pretty quick. Like, this thing doesn't project. It sits on your skin, but man, it just sticks around. Absolutely beautiful. Now, because I love that fragrance so much, I did go out and buy the parfum, and I bought Velvet Orchid. Velvet Orchid, I had smelled in an airport. It is sweeter. It isn't going to have the truffle note. This one is more of a woman's fragrance, so maybe I made a mistake buying this one. This one, though, I would say is not worth the upgrade. It smells too much like the original. I really didn't see much of a difference. The longevity of the original is great. So if you're going to choose one, go with the original. Now, as you're watching this video, you're hearing me throw around words like EDT, Eau de Toilette, EDP, Eau de Parfum, Parfum. What exactly does all this mean? Well, down in the description of today's video, I'm going to link over to some helpful videos I created actually on another channel, Centeno. I know, pretty clever, right? Took my last name, added an S to it. But on this fragrance channel, in less than a minute, I explain the difference. Actually, I look at Bleu de Chanel, Chanel being our next house, and I explain the difference between the EDP, between the EDT, and the parfum, and what you're paying for. And I'll tell you, in theory, you should be getting something stronger with more of a concentration. Not always the case. In fact, rarely the case nowadays. A lot of times, the perfumers, they want to have fun. They want to change things up. Now, am I going to say the parfum is, or the EDP is better than this EDT original? The answer is no. In my opinion, the EDT actually lasts longer, projects better, and is less expensive. So I'm going to recommend, well, I almost put this on the list. Bleu de Chanel you cannot go wrong with, but there were a couple other Chanels I wanted to add to this list. And I thought about going with something like Antaeus, which is a fragrance by Chanel that most men have never heard of. You can imagine if you want to smell like a masculine man from the 1970s, when you're wearing a tuxedo, this is the fragrance that you're going to want to wear. But it's not going to be the first one, the one that I would go to if I had to choose one Chanel fragrance. Now, that honor is going to go to Allure Homme Sport Eau Extreme. Now, there are variations of this. This is going to be the most extreme one, the strongest concentration. And I do like the smell. Compared to, especially like the cologne, which I really like, it's more citrusy, but it's not nearly going to last as long. This one, citrus cream, it's just a beautiful fragrance that the only knock on it is I wish it lasted longer. But unfortunately, that's the issue with all Chanel fragrances. Now, top notes on this fragrance are going to be mandarin orange, mint, cypress, and sage. Middle notes, pepper. Base notes, tonka bean, musk, sandalwood, and cedar. So my reasoning for putting this fragrance as the one Chanel I would go with is versatility. This is a fragrance that you can wear to the office, you can wear it on a date, you can wear this fragrance pretty much anywhere. On the weekend, just wearing a suit, you can wear it during the weekday, wearing shorts and t-shirt. This is a versatile fragrance year-round. You could wear this fragrance, and for that reason, I'm adding it to my list. Next up on this list, we've got a fragrance house that I could not pronounce for years, and that is Yves Saint Laurent. And the fragrance that I think is really safe, if you want something incredibly versatile, check out the YEDP. This one you can find on shelf stores around there. It's just got a really nice breakout, a very safe fragrance, but it's not going to be the one that I would choose if I could only go with one Yves Saint Laurent. Now, a lot of you guys may think it's going to be La Nuit. This is a beautiful fragrance. Definitely one of my first loves. This was in my top 10 list for a long time. A number of YouTubers highly recommended it, and for good reason. Solid fragrance. Now it's kind of slipped out. It's become a little bit boring. This is just sweet. It's beautiful, but I believe it's a bit overplayed. Now, the Yves Saint Laurent I'm gonna go with is Koros. You spray this on your chest, hair is gonna start to sprout. Seriously, the other day, I only had 8. Spray this, all of a sudden, I jumped to 16 within a week.
Say what?
Just beautiful. And what I also like about this, you can find this at discounters. I do recommend if you can find a deal on it, go ahead and blind buy it. If you can't find a deal, go in and definitely try to smell this. It's a masculine powerhouse. And if you want to smell, you want to smell different than the rest of the guys out there, and you've got the courage, you've got the conviction that you think you can pull this off, give it a shot. Now, gents, I know I mispronounce fragrances all the time, but I'm getting better. And if you've seen some improvement, do me a favor, smash that like button. Seriously, guys, by smashing that like button, engaging with these videos, it helps reach more people, and I do appreciate it. And if you've got something to add, if you disagree with some of these fragrances I'm putting out, like Antonio, why didn't you choose this one? Let me know. I love hearing from you guys. Love interacting, leaving snarky comments sometimes. So look forward to hearing from you. Now, this next house has so many great choices. Again, you see I'm running into this theme. Here's the thing. If they've been around for a while, if they put out a lot of fragrances, 95% of fragrances that are put out, they're really, really good. Maybe personally, you don't like something. You don't like vanilla. Maybe you don't like oceanic smells. I get it. But still, the vast majority of the fragrances out there are good. So when you find something and you find a house that works, don't feel like you got to go out there and buy hundreds of fragrances like fanatics like me. What I would recommend is just simply sticking with it and wearing it and getting the most out of it. Now, this one right here, Armani Code Absolute. Absolutely, it's my favorite of the Armani Codes. It's sweet vanilla, maybe overly sweet for some of you guys. Then if that's the case, check out the new Armani Code. I think that's the EDP or whichever one. Yeah, I've got it somewhere, but I'm not putting it on my list. Acqua di Gio Profumo. This is my favorite of the Acqua di Gios. That being said, Profundo and Profundo Lights are really nice. Even the original, it's a little bit weak. It's a little bit dated, but it's still good. This one right here, though, came very close to being the fragrance would be my go-to, but we're entering the winter. I wanted to go with something a little bit stronger, a little bit sweeter. And so my choice for my one Armani fragrance would be Stronger With You. Now, I have to admit, I resisted buying this fragrance for a while because I thought the name was absolutely stupid. I still do. That being said, it is just a beautiful winter scent. Top notes are going to be cardamom, pink pepper, violet leaf, and mint. Middle notes, pineapple, sage, melon, cinnamon, and lavender. Base notes, vanilla, chestnut, amberwood, cedar, guaiac wood. To me, it's the cardamom, the cinnamon, and the chestnut. That nut in there just really is a distinctive smell, and this is what separates this boozy, rich fragrance from a lot of the other ones out there. Now, you may be wondering, should I check out some of the flankers, like Intensely? It's gonna cost more, a little bit harder to find, or should I go with that new one? Absolutely. I would say the differences are minimum. I mean, really, I spent a lot of money to get this one over from Europe, and it's good, really nice, but I didn't see that much of a difference. It doesn't justify. These other ones are great if you happen to find them on sale, but go with the original. In my opinion, you're going to get the best deal on it. Now, guys, if you've made it this far into the video, you are either into fragrances, you are bored out of your mind, or you're interested in learning more about the power of scent. And if that is you, check this out. So this is the prototype. I've been talking about this. My project over at Mission Fragrances. You ready? You ready for the reveal? Absolutely beautiful. Ooh, look at that. Ooh, isn't that looking good? Now, gents, I've been talking about my project over at Mission Fragrances for the last year, and if you haven't yet, down in the description of today's video, I'm linking over to the page where you can sign up for the early bird list. If you're at all interested in how the science of smell can help make you more productive, help you get more out of life, help you improve, I mean, if you're training up for an Ironman, if you're going to be giving a presentation in front of your boss's boss and you get nervous, you want to be able to leverage the power of scent and conditioning. It's a real thing. Think about it. Whenever you smell coffee, what do? You sort of wake up. It just pulls you out of bed. Whenever you smell certain foods, it actually not only makes you hungry and salivate, but it makes you happier if they're foods you like. All this stuff is backed by science. And the more I did research on these, on all this information, I was like, why isn't the fragrance industry talking about this? So what we did, all of these are unique scents. And that's one of the key parts to being able to condition yourself with a fragrance. You need something you haven't smelt before, something that is unique. And it can just be a small, slight tweak in the notes, but that's going to be part of it. We also have a course that people can go through. This is about the bigger mission. And that's why, you know, I call it Mission Fragrances. I may change the name. Notice I'm only going with the MF right here. I may call it Mental Focus or something. But if you want to be part of something big, if you want to get the best deal out there, because the guys on my early bird list are going to get access to the best deals. I'm going to have extra bonuses and things I'm going to throw in there. But we are launching here soon, guys. I'm talking about October. I said it, so I got to stick with it. But yes, we're not shipping the fragrances out till November, but by October, we're going to start taking pre-sales. So make sure you are on the early bird list. I'm linking to it down in the description of today's video. Go over to missionfragrances.com. Give me your email address. I promise I'm not going to sell it, spam you. I'm just going to simply let you know when we're launching this thing. This is a limited run. I'm going to probably hopefully sell out this holiday season, and then it will be a few months and we're going to go back and we're going to learn. We're going to work with the guys. This is so much more than smelling great. It's the science of scent, guys. As you can tell, I'm pumped about this. This is unique. No one else is doing anything like this. And if you're interested in learning more, again, that link is in the description. Next up, we got a fragrance house that flies under the radar for most men. And that's too bad because they've really got some solid fragrances, even though they don't seem to put out a whole lot for men. And that is going to be Hermes. So right here, I've got Voyage. If this would win the award for the coolest bottle, I'd give it to it. And it's a solid fragrance, a little bit weak, but it's a good fragrance. Not necessarily the one I would put on this list, but I just love that bottle. My daughter does too. They also just came out with H24. This one got a really unique metallic note. Overall, just a really nice aromatic fragrance. I like this one, but it did not dethrone, in my opinion, the king of Hermes fragrances. And that king is the Woody Spicy Citrus Terre d'Hermes. They came out in 2006. Top notes are orange and grapefruit. Middle notes, pepper and pelargonium. Base notes, vetiver, cedar, patchouli, and benzoin. Now I'll be straight, those notes aren't that inspiring. In fact, when you see some people describe this fragrance as smelling like a dirty orange, what does that mean? I did another video and I went out there and did all this research. For some reason, when women smell this, they are drawn to it. When guys smell it, they love it. It is an amazing fragrance. If you are a serious collector and you don't have this in your collection, if you're just starting out and you're looking for a fragrance that is gonna do everything for you, it's versatile, four seasons. You can wear this on dates. You can wear this in the office. This is a fragrance going to get you compliments, yet it's never going to overpower. It's a masterpiece fragrance. I easily would put this in my top 10. And for that reason, I'm going to say definitely I would have this on my list as the number one. And the other ones, the Parfum and the Vetiver, those are good too. But start with the original. This one is where it's at. Now, speaking of a great deal, this next house, Versace. What I love about them is if you look around, you can find some great deals on these fragrances. They're going to be at discounters. They're going to be, you know, at big box stores. And the fragrances, though, are solid. The vast majority of them, they may be a little bit weak here or there, maybe Pour Homme, which I almost put on this list. Love it for the summer. But you know, right here, Dylan Blue, this one you could wear four seasons. And if you're looking for an alternative to Bleu de Chanel, you want a blue fragrance, but you don't want to pay as much money, look for this one. But it's not going to going to make my list, and what almost made the list, but it's not summertime, is Manafresh. This one, again, you could find this at Sam's, you can find this at Walmart, you can find this at Costco. Just simply look around and boom, you're going to be able to save money. And this one is a beautiful summer scent. That being said, we're entering the winter. So let's talk about Eros. Now, I do like Eros Flame. Very good fragrance. And I like the EDP that just came out. This is the EDT. And so both the EDT and the EDP are solid fragrances. The only difference, I would say, the EDT is slightly for a little bit younger guy, a younger party guy. The EDP for a little bit older party guy. Both of them do the same thing. The mint a little bit weaker over on the EDP. The mint is stronger here on the opening, but this fragrance right here is the perfect clubbing fragrance. In fact, that's why it's probably so popular. So this next house gets a lot of crap for smelling synthetic, and some of its fragrances do. That being said, some of them just smell amazing. Invictus Aqua. What am I talking about? Paco Rabanne. Based out of Spain, these guys, I think, have some great fragrances. They also have some ones you're going to want to pass on, but Invictus Aqua. Notice I didn't say just Invictus. The Aqua is the one that really stands out, but it wouldn't be the one I would go with. What I go with, their new one, and they love these outlandish bottles. This one right here, you're going to see this out there, Phantom, getting a lot of hype right now. It's, I think, a solid fragrance. That being said, I mean, it's unique. I wouldn't say it's something I'm going to wear all the time. Definitely not going to be in my top 25 fragrances. But for a new fragrance, something coming out there, and if you want to smell different for a while, you know, go out there and get it. Most people, because it's not discounters, this one you are going to probably pay full retail for. But the one that I would keep, 1 million Privé. Warm, spicy, cinnamon, sweet. It's got longevity. This thing is just absolutely beautiful. Maybe it's that cinnamon mixed in with the tobacco, with the myrrh, with a little bit of that tonka bean, actually a good amount of that tonka bean at the base. This is one of those fragrances, I have to admit, it's usually on one of my top lists. Even though it's relatively inexpensive, even though I've had some people turn up their nose to this fragrance, I get compliments, it seems like, every time I wear this fragrance. So for that reason, I just kept wearing it. Maybe it's because I keep wearing it because I feel good when I wear this fragrance, but it's a relatively cheap one that you can find at discounters. And again, I get crazy compliments. Anyone else ever gotten a compliment with 1 million? And 1 million is good too, and 1 million lucky isn't bad. And the new parfum is solid as well. And next, let's talk about the house of Dolce & Gabbana. No, the EDP King or K, whatever you want to call it, is not going to be on my list. This is an improvement from the EDT, but it's still, yeah, it's just a little bit too generic. It's a fine fragrance if you want something that's versatile and you can wear in the office, but wouldn't be in my top pick. Now, the easy pick here would have been Dolce & Gabbana's The One. And this one easily could have made the list, probably should have, because, you know, it's entering wintertime. But I wanted to bring you guys something cleaner, a little bit something new, something that's bright and fresh. But the EDP right here, this one is solid, better in my opinion than the EDT. The EDT is good as well. The EDP is just simply stronger, as an EDP should be. Now, the one I would keep is Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. But not this one, because as many of you guys know, I put this on my shooting list, and that video will be coming because you guys did engage with the video and give me the number of likes. And the reason that Light Blue is so low is because it's weak. It disappears, and it could have been so much more. And they actually fixed it with the Eau Intense. That being said, I'm going to go with Forever. This one, brand new, at least in the last 6 months. And yeah, I love that grapefruit opening. It's the most unique grapefruit, like strongest opening I've ever smelled, and I have to give it to them. This is the perfect summer scent. A solid fragrance, and it's got good longevity, so much better than the original. All right, gents, agree, disagree? Let me know down in the comments. Should I do a part two? There were certain houses I didn't cover, and yeah, I have enough that I can make another video like this. So, what video to watch next? How about my top fall picks? This one right here, I break out the fragrances you should be wearing right now. Okay, you don't have to wear them. I think that they're great ones, and I think that I chose some fragrances that a lot of you guys haven't even considered. So check out that video right here.